Coming up, Konnie sneaks behind the scenes to spy in the cast of Am I High? Okay, Agent Jones.
What?
Coast Cliff.
Where? Where are we going now?
Keep down.
Shh, Mabel. Shh,
you have to be
Mabel.
Subtle.
Mabel, okay, so
yeah,
loud.
That's good.
Shh.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Yes. Now we're talking in hushed tones and the lights are down because we've got a top secret competition later in the show, but it's top secret, so mum's the word.
Shh. Hey, look yeah. over there. Look over there.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a clue for you over there.
Oh, yeah.
Any ideas? Any ideas? What do you think, Liz?
Oh, wow, hello? Guys. Come, yes,
Zoe,
what?
Zoe, come and sit down. Shh.
What's
that? Anyway, sit down. Shh. Sit
Mabel.
Down. Quiet. Shh.
There we are. Shh. Whispering.
We're whispering. Well, Agent Huq is teaching me how to be a secret agent,
yeah,
of course.
That's right. That's right, Agent Jones, because I know all about what it takes to be a top secret spy.
Welcome to MI High.
Here we go. Happy Jones. And action.
Let me fill you in on the plot. An MI9 agent has to find secure and untraceable identities for his field officers. His solution is simple yet brilliant: to establish a brand new ring of undercover spies situated somewhere where the enemy will never suspect, in an underachieving inner city state school.
What is it with boys in those dumb computer games?
I play Daisy Miller. She's a bit of a rich, posh girl, but she doesn't really want anyone to know that, because I think she's quite embarrassed about it, because she just goes to a normal state school, so no one else is really like that. She's very popular, and everyone knows her, and she has her little posse, and she's not very nice to Rose, who's another spy. She's a bit of a geek.
All I know is that scarves do nothing for my neckline.
Well, some people care about more than how they look.
Yeah, you, obviously.
I play Rose Gupta. She's the clever one out of the three spies, and in school she's quiet. But then when it's spy, she gets down to business.
Would you say her character's similar to what you're like in real life?
No, because she's quite quiet and to herself, but I'm quite open and social and quite loud.
They said that I got the part because I was the closest to Daisy, but I don't think that. Because she's a bit of a bimbo at times.
Oh.
I like to think that I'm not stupid.
So, MI9 recruits three teenagers. The big question is, how will it be saving the world, handing in your homework on time, and maintaining your identity as a secret? I'm gonna let you in on some privileged information. I'm not only interested in MI High because it's gonna be a great watch, but I've also got a little part in it which is going to be filmed in a top location, the Blue Peter Garden.
Do you know anything about the episode?
Yeah, it's called The Big Freeze, isn't it?
Yeah.
And you're the reporter.
All is going to plan.
The Grandmaster, who's like the evil guy, gets a weather girl to make a machine that can change the weather. And she freezes Britain, and everything gets really cold.
Uh-oh.
And this is how you change midsummer into midwinter. The powder is really just tiny bits of paper. The director is Simon Huq.
It's supposed to be a really cold spell.
Okay.
As you can tell, it's actually the hottest week of the year.
Yes, definitely.
And you are going to get wrapped up in lots of layers, duffel coats.
No.
You're going to be jumping around.
No, it's
trying
so
to keep,
hot.
Trying to keep warm, and it's actually going to be 80 degrees or something.
But no dressing up quite yet, because my first task was to make a weather machine out of plastic bottles and cardboard tubes.
Okay. So the idea is you're sort of trying to do it, and you're all fingers and thumbs, you're trying to get the sellotape around there, and eventually you just go, oh, here's one I made of it, and it collapses.
Yeah.
Right, run out then, please, Harvey. Thanks. Okay, 4:38, part take one. Action.
So what you need to do next is get your two kitchen rolls and your toilet roll. And what we're going to do is we're going to stick them... And what we're going to do is we're going to stick them onto our machine so far. So that... Oh, there we go. Here's one that I made a little bit earlier.
OK, we've cut there. Thank
Brilliant.
You. Thanks, Cherry. They can carry on their work for a moment.
That's it.
These are all my layers. How many layers do you reckon I'm wearing in total?
About 15.
I had to use ice packs to keep me cool.
Thank you.
Here we go. Jumper number one. Oh, I'm so glad for my ice packs.
Take four, take one. I'm set. And action.
Hello and welcome to a live Blue Peter special all about global warming.
Hello,
now, those of you who
Connie.
Are watching the news will know that the usually freezing Arctic is sweltering. Now, this topsy-turvy global warming has reached Great Britain.
And because it was supposed to be getting colder, it was time for more layers.
But today's drastic drop in temperature is something of a phenomenon. The thermometer is now reading a toe-numbing minus 10.
So while the storyline got even colder...
Bring it on. Give me more layers.
I got even hotter. And my misery was only just beginning.
OK, I've got an idea of how we can get this in one, actually.
Okay.
To make everyone happy.
Action.
Roger Powell, just the one A-level?
Sonia sort of helped me design this, but what exactly are you implying?
Never mind the sweat, just look at the icicles.
You're just a few stages from actually being frozen solid.
Okay, yeah.
If it was another scene after this, it would be you actually in a block of ice, yeah.
We do apologise for that interruption, which seems to have been from Sonia Frost. She's the one who told us that the girls last year were nothing to worry about. Still seems she's a little bit balmy.
Well done. Thanks very much, folks. That's a wrap.
I tell you, I don't think I've been hotter than that in my whole life. I just want to collapse and sleep and be cold in an ice bath.